came along those boards. Ciccone hitting at Van Dorp. Ciccone wants Van Dorp, and he's got him.
Well, Enrico Ciccone was looking for that all the way. He went right after Van Dorp. Van Dorp, I think, knew that that was going to end up happening as well.
Well, there'll be majors there and maybe an instigating minor to Enrico Ciccone.
What happens, there's Van Dorp, 24. There's Ciccone right there. Now watch, Ciccone just stays with him, pushes up, drops his gloves first. Van Dorp didn't realize right away that he was in it. They exchanged some pretty good punches. Enrico Ciccone.
They're in, all the way down by Chris Terreri. Danico and Tockett.
You know, Gary, this, you'd almost think they would have had to have started during the three-on-one. Because right after the three-on-one, the players started pointing down at the other end.
Well, most everybody missed that except Chris Terreri, who was standing down there watching. Barr from Chorsky and Driver at 5-10. One of these you're going to see. The Blackhawks are second in the National Hockey League in penalty minutes. The Devils have the fourth fewest, and they're going to be going at it tonight because the Blackhawks have decided they're going back to their old black and blue ways.
But Pelusa, who leads the National Hockey League with 300 minutes now, 305, probably 307, because I think he'll get the instigator in this. He reached across and gave McKay a little shot. But of course, Randy McKay played last year for the Detroit Red Wings. He played 8 games against the Blackhawks, probably a lot of them against Mike Pelusa.
McKay, 5 for fighting.
Mike Pelusa, 5 minutes for fighting.
And Peluso, 5 for fighting, and there is no instigator.
Good job, but I'll tell you, Peluso is huge. He is an absolute mountain out there.
He's there, and finally gives Belfour the whistle. And there's Randy McKay in the corner again. Here we go with Cam Russell.
McKay, who came into this game with 21 fighting majors for the Devils, he led them in penalty minutes with 202.
Our second fight of the game, McKay has been involved in both. Only 2:25 left. He'll head for the runway. Hawks and Devils, one each.
Coming up on Minnesota, Basil McRae and Kenny Baumgartner drop the gloves here.
Written invitation not needed. McRae heads for a dressing room. Baumgartner heads for the dressing room. And Eddie, why don't we
That's right at the Washington bench. Here's Krstic and Brendeborg. Look at Krstic.
Krstic doing a good job standing
absolutely.
Up. He's very strong in his skates. And Brendeborg, pretty tough customer. He's big and strong, lifts a lot of weights. But those two guys collided right in front of the bench.
And Krstic did not back. Here's Kordick and Alan May.
The big Dan Kordick inserted into the lineup. He wasn't supposed to play, but Howe's chronic back problems acted up. He's out there, and he's one tough customer, much like his younger brother, or older brother, excuse me, John Kordick, who used to play for the Caps. These guys really battling. That's going to take a lot out of you, standing there wrestling, trying to get your punches away.
The linesman waiting for the opportune time to get in here, and we got two heavyweights going. Big Dan Kordick of the penalties, and here it is. Huffman with the hard hit, and then Kordick. Could you call that one the third man in or what?
Not really. It wasn't a real altercation, but here's where it started. Alan May, both guys threw off their gloves pretty quick. You can tell it's a long battle. When they got up at the end of this, both guys throwing a lot of punches. The linesman just says, you're done. Pat DeBuzzo jumped on him. They didn't even move. They both got up, just went to their penalty boxes.
Now, old-time Flyer Capitals hockey here in the first period.
Breaking out, Cronin and Jay Miller. Well, they had words in the first period. Never got to one another, but they do now. So here's a couple of heavyweights in a battle, and they've got each other tied up pretty good right at the blue line of the Winnipeg Jets. And Cronin wrestles Jay Miller down to the ice. 2 points for a takedown, and that's going to be the end of that. So more of a wrestling match than anything else. And now Jay Miller upset.
Out of it, now a fight, Horacek. And Chase on the far side. Chase has landed a right hand. Now Horacek is knocked down by Chase. And the linesmen jump in. That happened behind the play. And Kelly Chase, who always has a fight here in Chicago, gets in one here with Horacek.
So back behind the play, gloves off, linesman watching, to say nothing of over 18,000. They let him go, and Kimball decks Peluso with a couple of rights. Both of them getting some pretty good shots, and the linesman can't separate them. And Peluso really hammering Kimball as they got loose from the linesman, who now are back in control. Big Mike Peluso of the Hawks and Darren Kimball of the Blues. Kimball considers himself a winner. And he'll go.
Zaccone, and there go the gloves. Enrico Zaccone and Randy McKay. For your opera enjoyment. Zaccone's played in just 8 games now. He's got 32 penalty minutes in the previous 8. Randy McKay, of course, has been challenged by everybody. 212 penalty minutes, and he wins another one. We'll be back. No score.